Good evening everyone, welcome to GradeUp's MBA Prep channel. Welcome to this series of targeting 50 out of 50 in MHCET Quant and DI section. So we've had some classes in the past and I'm sure you must have attended those classes, right? And you must have seen that we have covered some of the topics. We have covered number series, approximations, then we had some questions on ratios, percentages, etc. So today we are going to do time, speed and distance. Okay, time, speed and distance, something a widely talked about topic. It contains different kind of questions, as people say, right? But I'll teach you that just one concept you need to remember for the entire chapter, and using that we'll see that all sorts of problems can be solved. So I'll change your way of how you solve questions right now, right? And you will find a better way to, better techniques to solve questions, and in a better way to solve them, right? So good evening all, welcome to this session, and please do like the session if you enjoy it, and do share it with your friends. So on 24th of July we have these people, Mr. Abhishek Rajadhyaksh. He was a cricketer and he converted JBIMS. So he'll be telling about his journey, how he converted. And we have Urvika Sonar. She is also an alumnus of JBIMS. So these MHCET toppers will be giving the talks. So we have one session at 3 p.m. on GradeUp app, and and another at 9 p.m. on GradeUp's YouTube channel. So don't miss these sessions. These are these sort of valuable sessions that help you, that motivate you, that help you that how to prepare for the examinations and beyond. Okay, so I had given a couple of questions in the last class. Some of you had commented the answers. Okay, so I told you, so in the classes we had thus far, I had given you certain techniques how to use variables, right? So this question said that in class of 165 students, 1/5 of the girls and 3/5 of the boys join a culture club, right? So if there are 1/5 of the girls, we know that 1/5 of girls will be an integer. Number of people is always an integer, right? So instead of taking the variables as x and y, so let me take the number of girls as 5x and the number of boys as 5y. Do you know why? Because 1/5 will be x and 3/5 will be y. So how many joined cultural club? So if you talk about the people who joined cultural club, right? So there are x girls and 3y boys, okay? The ratio of the number of boys and girls joining the club, culture club, is 12:7. So it is saying 3y ratio x is equal to 12:7. So this gives you y ratio x as 4:7. So it is saying boys to girls, right? Boys is y and girls is x. So the answer is 4:7, right? So it is the importance of taking the right variables. If you take the variables correct, right, you can solve it within few minutes, within few seconds. Otherwise, some people will take x and then say x upon 5, 3y upon 5. Why to take that, right? So just take variables as girls, number of girls as 5x, number of boys as 5y. So you get these, the ones who join culture club, these are the girls who join, these are the boys who join. Okay, so that was one of the questions. Then one question was on mixtures, right? I taught you, that was a simple one. 75 liters of honey, right? So 75 and 2/5 of the honey is replaced by milk. So 1 minus 2 by 5. And how many times it is done? 2 times, right? So 75 into, that is 3 by 5. So 3 by 5 into 3 by 5. So that is 3 into 3 into 3, 27. So this will be honey, right? And it has asked for honey to milk. So honey is 27, milk will be 48, the ratio will be 9:16. Okay, so these were the answers to the two questions that we had last time. Okay, all right, so let us start. Let us start today's session. Let us look for time, speed and distance. Okay, so this is our YouTube schedule. Please subscribe to our channel. You can view different classes at different timings. We have daily editorial at 10 a.m. every day. Then we have VRC sessions, quant sessions, DILR sessions, etc., taken up by different faculty members who teach at GradeUp. Okay. And we have launched course for CAT 2022. In case you are preparing for the examination or some you know someone else who would be preparing, you can recommend them to us. Okay, all right. Now, speed, time and distance, right? People treat different things. Today we will learn, जैसे हमने percentages में देखा था कि percentages, simple interest, compound interest, right? Profit loss, everything is just based on percentages, right? So today we will see time, speed and distance. Just one thing to remember, there is just one formula, that distance is equal to speed into time, right? You can call it time equal to distance upon speed, or call it speed is equal to distance upon time, right? Just one thing you need to remember, right? Now what happens is, the definition of speed might change, the definition of distance might change, right? What happens to speed when there are two bodies? If there are two bodies, speed is the relative speed, and if the length of bodies is involved, distance is the sum of lengths. Okay, so we will see that concept in trains and solve questions based on this concept. Okay, so just remember that you just should know that distance is equal to speed into time. Now, distance is directly proportional to speed. Distance is directly proportional to time, which means if you increase the speed, the distance will increase. If you increase the time, the distance will increase. However, speed and time are inversely proportional. So if you increase the speed, so suppose the ratio of speeds is 2:3, right? So the time taken will be 3:2. Okay, so that is inversely proportional. So these things you get from this equation. Now there is a concept called relative speed. Okay, when there are two bodies that are moving, okay, and if they are moving in opposite direction, if they move in opposite direction, you speed add their speeds. So suppose he is moving with 15 meter per second, right, and she is moving with 12 meter per second. So the relative speed will be 27 meter per second. Suppose it is 15, this is 12, so the relative speed will be 3 meter per second. So whenever you have two bodies moving, in that thing which I told you, that distance is equal to time into speed. Okay, so this speed will mean this speed. Okay, if there are two people moving, you will consider this speed. Okay, all right, so let us start with the questions and we will see wherever, whatever concept, whatever tricks and tips that will be helpful for you. Okay, the ratio of speeds of a car and a train is 18:25. If the speed of the train is 28 kilometer per hour more than that of the car, what is the speed of the car? Acha, conversion table I didn't show. Okay, I'll show it later. Right, I'll show you the conversion table from kilometer per hour to this. So if you have to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, right, you multiply by 5/18, right, or you divide by 3.6. If you have to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour, right, what you do is you multiply by 18/5, or in other words, you multiply by 3.6. Now sometimes what happens is, we are in a hurry, right? So some people say car and train 18:25. It is saying speed of car 18 ka multiple hona chahiye. Some people will blindly mark 18 as the answer. Common mistake, right? So I'll tell the mistakes also people commit, right? If you are in a hurry, you see 18, okay, so this will be the answer. No, now see this, it is in meter per second. The data given is in 20 kilometer per hour, right? So suppose the speed is 18x and 25x, the difference is 28, right? So 7x is equal to 28, x equal to 4. Okay, so it is asking about car. Car will be 18 into 4, 72. 72 kilometer per hour, that is 20 meter per second. Okay, 72 into 5/18, that is 20 meter per second. Okay, so not necessarily, if you see 18 25, so it will be a multiple of 18, right? So you need to convert the units also. That is also important thing to do. Okay, all right, so that was an easy one. Okay, so let's see the next one. Excluding stoppages, the speed of a bus is 90 kilometer per hour, and including stoppages, it is 75 kilometer per hour. For how many minutes does the bus stop per hour? Now this is a question that people have confusion. how to solve this kind of questions, right? So I'll tell you two methods. One is using the concept of time speed distance. One is another thing which we have already learned, which is allegation. Okay, these type of questions are also asked, that including stoppages, excluding stoppages, right? The ones who are taking the difference will get the answer as 15, right? Some people will just say 90 minus 75. No, that you not have to do. You do not have to subtract it. So how do we do this is, you substitute, you assume the distance to be this distance, right? Including stoppage wala distance, right? Let us put D equal to 75. If distance is 75, what will be the time taken? Time will be 1 hour, right? So if you include stoppage, including stop, you are taking 1 hour, okay? When you do not stop, when you run non-stop, so without stop, how much time will you take? Time is distance upon speed, right? Distance is 75, speed is how much? 90. That is into minutes, right? This is in hours, you convert it to minutes. So 5 by 6 hours or 50 minutes, right? You take 50 minutes. Okay, so when you are not stopping, you are going in 50 minutes. When you are stopping, you are taking 1 hour. So for how much are you stopping? You are stopping for 10 minutes. Stop time is 10 minutes. Now instead of writing all this, how do we do this is, find the difference 15 by the non-stop speed, right? 15 by 90 is 1 by 6, right? 1 by 6 hour, that is equal to 10 minutes. Okay, the difference between these speeds divided by your this thing, your non-stop speed. Okay, so this is how we get the answer, 10 minutes. Okay, another way to do, interesting, we learned that in allegations, isn't it? We did allegations na? Acha, now if it is moving, suppose the bus is moving, what will be its speed? 90. If it is stopped, its speed is 0. Okay, what is the average speed of the bus? 75. So this is 75, this is 15, 5:1. Okay, 5:1 means 15 is movie time, stop time is 10. So you find another application of allegations. Okay, interesting application. You would not have thought of, many people would not have thought of this thing, ki it is possible using that also, right? So allegation is a very powerful tool which we did in the last class. Okay, so you can do this way as well, right? This is another way to do it, right? Otherwise, just remember the speed difference, that is 15 divided by the non-stop speed. Okay, that is the time, stop time. Okay, 10 minutes. Okay, all right. A person walks a certain distance at 4 km per hour and returns at 3 km per hour. If the total time taken by him in going and returning is 8 hours 45 minutes, the total distance walked by him is. What is the total distance walked by the person? How do we do these kind of questions? So I'll be taking different variety of questions, the possible variants of questions that you get in from this topic, and see that how those could be done in the best possible manner. Not in every question. Not in every question. Allegation can be used in places wherein you have like two different kind of activities. One is top activity, like you have bifurcation of two parts, right? Like we saw in the last class also, simple interest two portions. Here also speed of two types. One is topping speed, one is moving speed. Okay. Achha, how do we do these questions? Is one way is the way that the normal way that you do, right? So normal way is that suppose the distance is d on one side. Okay, suppose the distance on one side is d. Okay, so I told you to remember one thing, that t is d, right? Distance is known to me, speed is known to me. What is time in this case? Time will be d upon 4. Okay, so when you go to this direction, when you return, your time is d by 3. Okay, so the total time that is given to you is 8 hours 45 minutes. So that is d by 4 plus d by 3. 8 hours 45 minutes is 8 3 by 4 hours, right? So that is 35 by 4 hours. Okay, so if you take LCM, you will get 7d by 12, right, is equal to 35 by 4. So we'll get 5 times, 3 times. So d is 15, right? So one side distance, total distance will be 30. Okay, this is the way to do it, right? I mean, the logical way, that time is distance upon speed, this is to do, right? And how to do it in a better way is, remember that the speed, the net speed is 2ab upon a plus b, harmonic mean. Okay, so instead of speed, we will put 2ab, that is 2 7, and time is how much? So distance is equal to speed into time. Time is 8 3 by 4, that is 35 by 4. Okay, so you could directly put, you will get 30 as your answer. Okay, so average speed is this. In such cases, when a person is going same distance and returning the same distance, right, average speed is given by this. So that is the harmonic mean. You should know this thing. Okay, you should not be doing this way. I mean, this was the way how we did it, how a layman would do it. But as a smart person, you should know this thing, that average speed in that case is 2ab upon a plus b. Right, that is the harmonic mean of them. Okay. All right. So let's look at the next question. Okay. When a driver reduces his speed from 70 km per hour to 60 km per hour, he takes 20 minutes more than his usual time to reach his destination. Find the usual time taken by him to cover the distance. No, you cannot take average. I told you that you are not supposed to take arithmetic mean. You have to take harmonic mean. Okay, arithmetic mean is not the correct average. Now, I told you that in every question, we'll use the framework, TSD framework, right? TSD framework, time into speed is equal to distance, right? Whenever you get a question on time, speed, distance, use this framework, and we will see in different questions using this framework, how can we answer these questions, right? Even if you do not know ki isko kaise karte hain, usko kaise karte hain, we'll see everywhere it works. All those questions, ki wo school tej gaya, school se dheere aaya, those kind of questions they give, right? And they give that he takes this much time. So we'll see this and solve all these questions like this framework, right? Very simple thing to understand. If you understand this thing, I mean, questions are quite doable. Okay. Now some people will be confused between 140, 120. Theek hai, wo formula bhool jaate hain, right? Some people remember these things using formulae. Isn't it? They remember ki acha ye 6 ratio 7 hai to 20 ka ye karke dekhenge, 6 karenge, some will do into 6, some will do into 7, because they mug up the formula. Some people mug up these formulae, right? Wo kahenge ki 7 ratio 6 hai to 7, ek ne 7 se multiply kar diya, ek ne 6 se kar diya, kisi ka 120 aaya, 140 aaya, kya hona chahiye, right? So I'll tell you how to do this. Suppose usual time pucha na, usual time suppose is t, theek hai, and his speed is 70. Now if he is saying 20 minutes more, So he will be taking t plus 20 minutes in this case, and his speed is 60. The distance is same, right? Distance is same in both the cases, right? So 70t is equal to 60 times of t plus 20. ठीक है, 70 is equal to 60 plus 120, so t आ गया 120, that is 2 hours. Okay, so just put in this framework TSD. Time into speed is distance. So in both the cases, the distance is same, right? He is covering the same distance, isn't it? Formula याद करने की ज़रूरत ही नहीं है. Why to remember कि इसमें ये होता है, इसमें होता है? Too many things, right? I told you just remember one thing. Time into speed is distance. Okay. All right. Now this is a question on Head Start, and we'll see it how to do this question. Right? Head Start वाले question अगर आ गए race में, so how to do these? Okay. You get one or two questions from each of the topics, right? Quantity comparison में भी आ सकते हैं, data sufficiency भी आ सकता है, right? So concepts like all वैसे एक arithmetic problem की बात करें, you will get one to two questions from each of the topics. क्योंकि बहुत सारे topic हैं, 10-12 topic, 10-12 word problems आते हैं. Now what is Head Start? Head Start means if you tell someone to start ahead of you, ठीक है? होता है कई बार जैसे बच्चों के साथ रेस लगानी होती है, बच्चों से कहते हैं तुम आगे से दौड़ लो, हम पीछे से दौड़ लेंगे, ठीक है? So that is called Head Start. Now it is saying that Pulkit had a head start of 140 meters. So Pulkit was running 140 meter ahead, right? So Pulkit has to run 360 meter, ठीक है? Total Pulkit को run करना है 360 and this person has to run 500. Okay. Now it is saying that ratio of speeds of them is 4:5. Ratio of speed 4:5 है. So distance will also be in the 4:5 ratio. Okay. So Pulkit and Rajat will cover distance in the ratio 4:5. I told you distance is directly proportional to speed. ठीक है. Now if he is covering 360 meter. 4:5 है, so 360:450. So in the time he covers from here to here, this person will have covered 450 meters. ये 450 meters cover कर पाएगा, right? So Pulkit will win because he reached early, right? What is the distance left? 50 meters. So he will win by 50 meters. Okay, so this is the concept of head start. Right, head start means a person is starting ahead of someone else. Okay, so the answer is 50. Okay, circular race, that was linear race, then you could have circular race also, right? Two friends, Mukul and Nakul, simultaneously start running around a circular track. They run in the same direction. Mukul travels at 12 meter per second and Nakul runs at 20 meter per second. If perimeter of circular track is 60 meters, then after how many seconds they meet again at the starting point? Hi Varun, you're using some cool font. How do we do these kind of questions? Running around a circular track. So we are covering almost all varieties of questions that you can face in this topic. So see, the distance is 60 meters. What is the speed? 12 meter per second. So time will be 5 seconds. So Mukul will cover one circle in 5 seconds. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट सर्कल दे हैव टू मीट एट दिस पॉइंट ओनली, राइट? इजंट इट? सो 5 सेकंड्स ही विल कंप्लीट इन 10, 15, 20 एंड सो ऑन. ठीक है। नाउ नकुल इज गोइंग एट द स्पीड ऑफ 20, राइट। हाउ मच टाइम विल इट टेक टू कवर दिस? ही विल कवर इन 3 सेकेंड्स। नेक्स्ट ही विल कवर इन 6, देन 9। नाउ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इज, व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर टेकिंग मल्टीपल्स, राइट। दीज आर मल्टीपल्स, सो वेन देर आर मल्टीपल्स वट इज देयर? LCM, least common multiple, will find common multiples, right? He will cover distances in multiples of 3, he will cover in multiples of 5. So when is it common? When will they meet? When the multiple is common? So that is why you take LCM, right? So you understand what is LCM, why do we use LCM? So this is one of the applications of LCM, right? So what is common between 3 and 5? 15. So 15 seconds they will meet at starting point. Okay, so LCM of time taken by them to cover a route, that is the solution. So irrespective if they run in same direction or opposite direction, it does not matter, because they will complete the circle at that particular time itself, right? Even if he is running in this direction or this direction, they will complete the circle at that particular time interval. Okay. Now this is the concept of meeting at any point. Okay, meeting at any point. First was the concept in which they meet at the starting point. Starting points, remember that LCM of the time taken to complete one round. So one person is taking 5 seconds, another person is taking 3 seconds to complete the round. Okay, to take LCM of 5 and 3, that is 15. Now the next scenario is when they meet at any point, right? So meeting at the initial point is very simple. Find the time taken by them to complete one round, take LCM of that. That's it. Now for this, people remember the formulae, right? I told you one thing, this magical thing TSD, right? Time will remain the constant, because time is defined as time only, right? There is no other definition of time. Distance is circumference in this case, right? So suppose one is running in this direction, second person is running in this direction. When they meet, what will happen? The total distance is this, right? Speed is your relative speed. Distance is circumference. I told you, do not remember too many formulae, right? You get confused, right? So just remember one thing, TSD. S is the relative speed. Whenever there are two objects moving, the speed is always relative speed, right? And there is just one formula in this entire thing, TSD. Okay, I mean, instead of remembering too many formulae, train mein kya formula lagta hai, isme kya formula lagta hai, just remember this. So distance is 2400, okay? Now when they are running in the same direction mein run karenge to kya hoga, speed ka difference le loge, same direction mein speed kya ho jayegi, 18, right? 18 kilometer per hour, that is 5 meter per second, okay? Speed ho gayi 5. टाइम कितना हो जाएगा, डिवाइडेड 480, दैट मीन्स 8 मिनट्स. ओके, व्हेन दे गो इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में क्या जाएंगे, स्पीड विल एड अप, राइट. आई टोल्ड यू इन द बिगनिंग दैट रिलेटिव स्पीड विल बी 72, व्हिच इज 20 मीटर पर सेकेंड, डिवाइड बाय 20, यू गेट 120, व्हिच इज 2 मिनट्स. अब वो फॉर्मूले याद करते हैं लोग, दिस डिवाइडेड बाय दिस. इतने सब फॉर्मूले याद ही नहीं रखने. रिमेंबर, टाइम इनटू स्पीड इज डिस्टेंस. द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्पीड माइट चेंज, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिस्टेंस माइट चेंज, राइट. डिस्टेंस इन दिस केस इज द सर्कमफेरेंस, इजंट इट? and the speed is relative speed. Whenever there are two bodies moving, the speed that I'm using here should be the relative speed, right? Whenever there are two bodies moving, okay? And distance will depend on the scenario. So here the distance is circumference of the circle, because when they're covering the entire round, so they're covering a total distance of the circle, right? The circumference of circle. So as simple as that. No need to remember any formulae for different things, right? People remember formulae, right? Ideal that just remember this thing, base thing if you remember, right? You can solve any question, okay? Alright, so if you are enjoying this session, don't forget to like the session and please do subscribe to our channel as well for wonderful content that we have for MBA preparation, okay? Acha, this I should have shown you earlier, right? These are some things, if you solve a few questions, right, you will remember. No need to calculate these values. Theek hai, 5 or 18 ki table yaad honi chahiye, right? If you know the tables of 5 and 18, you can simply, remember these values. These are very frequently used values, right? If there are frequent values, you should know the values, right? Okay. Now coming to train questions. Okay. Train question. Let us see that how can we do train questions with this simplicity, right? Many of you might not have even realized ki train questions were that simple. People used to remember formulae, right? Ye hoga, wo hoga, aise and all. We will just use one framework, TSD. Okay, from now on, just remember that time, speed, distances, this chapter is called TSD, right? Because you just have to remember one thing. Now see this, I told you speed is whenever there are two bodies moving, right? Speed is the relative speed, distance is the length of object, sum of length. So when it comes to train problems, it is sum of lengths. Right? So sum of length is 720, so distance you put 720. Speed you have to find out, time is given to you, right? See, they will give you two things in TSD. They will give you time or speed, they will ask for distance, or they will give you speed and distance, they will ask for time, right? Or they will give you time and distance, they will ask for speed. Two things will be given to you, one thing is missing. What are they asking about? They are asking about speed. Okay, time they have given 24, distance you know is 720. What is speed? 30. Now this speed 30 is what? I told you this is not the speed of one thing. This is the relative speed, right? If their relative speed is what? If they are going in opposite direction, sum of speeds. If they are going in same direction, difference of speeds. Okay. So total speed is 30, right? 30. So one is going at 36 km per hour. If you this is meter per second, right? Because it is in meters and this is in seconds. So 30 meter per second. So S1 plus S2 is 30. Right, S1 is 10, so S2 will be of course 20. So your answer is 20 meter per second. This is how you can solve these questions like anything, right? So just remember, just put every question in this framework, and it hardly takes any time to solve questions, right? So it is asking speed, so it means time and distance should be given to you. Yes, they have given distance. Distance is what? Sum of length. Time is given to you, you get the speed. This speed is what? Relative speed. Remember, the definition of speed might change. When there are two bodies moving, it is relative speed. When there are two objects with lengths involved, the distance is the sum of length. When they are running around a circle, the distance is circumference of circle. So definition of distance and speed might change, right? But the concept will remain the same, the TSD, okay? All right, let's do this question. A train of length 220 meters crosses a platform in 40 seconds. If the train increases its speed by 3 meters per second, it can cross a pole in 11 seconds. Find the length of the platform. Can you solve this question in 11 seconds after reading it? 11 seconds will be too fast. Okay, definitely this can be done within 40 seconds. Such kind of questions can be tackled within 40 seconds. Now, what is given to you? They have given you two scenarios, right? Case 1, case 2. I mean, you are not supposed to write like this. I'm telling you this. Okay. So, in first case, what is happening? The train is crossing a platform, right? So, distance will be sum of length. Do you know the distance? No, you do not. Do you know the speed? No, you do not. Do you know the time? Yes, you know the time. So, whatever is known, you fill that. Second scenario. You know the speed? No. Right? It is increasing speed by 3, but you do not know the speed. Right? You know the time? Yes, 11 seconds. You know the distance? Yes. If it is crossing a pole, what is sum of length? Pole length is 0. So, distance is 220. Okay? If distance is 220, time is 11. What is speed? Speed will be 20. Right? Now, speed is 20. Now, it is saying that speed increased by 3. If it increased by 3, it becomes 20. So, it means originally speed was 17. And if speed was 17, 14 into 17, distance was 680. 680 means sum of length. 220 meter is of platform. So, what will be the length of this thing? So, 220 meter is train. Train plus platform is 680. So, subtract 220 from 680, you get 460. As I said, put this in this framework, right? You will find that, okay, so simple to solve questions, isn't it? Are you getting this? I mean, are you understanding this, what I am trying to convey this, right? You do not need to remember formula or something, right? In this case, time is known to you, distance is known, we found out speed. So, from this, we found this speed, time was known, so I found the distance, right? And distance is your sum of lengths. Okay. All right. So let's look at the next question. Two persons are walking in the same direction at speeds of 3 km per hour and 6 km per hour. A train going in the same direction passes them completely in 14 and 15 seconds respectively. Find the length of the train. What is the length of the train? Again, we'll use TST approach to solve this question. Okay. So, compound interest, I have already taken a class. Boats and streams also we are going to do today, right, in time, speed, distance. So, please watch till end. Right, boats and stream also is nothing difficult in that. Compound interest I taught in percentages and its applications, right? Mensuration also will have it, right? So we have some sessions lined up. We'll have classes one after the other. Okay, so got stuck in this, right? Because it is something new, right? Not getting answer to this question. How to do this? Away hota alag tarah ki problem aati hai. People got like people thinking अलग प्रॉब्लम आ गई, फंस गए, राइट? सो जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, टीएसडी, राइट? सो वी विल यूज दिस टीएसडी मेथड टू सॉल्व इट, ठीक है? नाउ टू पर्संस आर वॉकिंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, ठीक है? स्पीड हमें क्या दी है? स्पीड इज ऑलवेज द रिलेटिव स्पीड, ठीक है? स्पीड आई टोल्ड यू इज द रिलेटिव स्पीड, ओके? नाउ फर्स्ट केस में स्पीड दी है, नहीं दी है. Right, speed is means they have given you the speed of men, right? Do not take 3 and 6. I told you this is relative speed. Okay, so 3 and 6 ki speed se ja rahe hai. Train bhi to ja rahi hai na. So you will consider train also. सपोज ट्रेन की स्पीड एक्स मान लेते हैं, ठीक है, सपोज दैट स्पीड ऑफ ट्रेन इज एक्स, सो इफ दे आर गोइंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, सेम डायरेक्शन में क्या होता है स्पीड सब्ट्रैक्ट कर देते हैं, तो स्पीड क्या हो जाएगी एक्स माइनस थ्री, ठीक है, और टाइम कितना दिया है 14, ठीक है। दूसरे केस में क्या है, टाइम दिया है 15, स्पीड कितनी है एक्स माइनस सिक्स, ठीक है। टाइम इंटू स्पीड इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस, डिस्टेंस मीन्स लेंथ ऑफ ट्रेन, दोनों केस में सेम डिस्टेंस होगा, इक्वेट दिस 14x माइनस 3 इक्वल्स टू 15x माइनस 6, सो वी विल गेट 14x माइनस 42 इक्वल्स 15x माइनस 40 90, सो दैट गिव्स यू x इज इक्वल टू 48, ठीक है, x इज 48, मतलब जो हम ये ले रहे थे वो 48 है, ठीक है। सो नाउ लेट्स पुट 48 in any of the equations, right? Put x equal to 48 in any of the equations. Do not put in both, ठीक है? Any किसी में भी भर दो. So if I put x equal to 48, 14 into 45. अब ये जो x लिया था, ये हमने लिया किलोमीटर पर आर में, ठीक है? We took this in किलोमीटर पर आर. अब हमें क्या निकालना है? मीटर्स में निकालना है, ठीक है? ये क्या निकालना है? मीटर्स में निकालना है. So we will convert to meter per second. ठीक है, बिकॉज दिस डिस्टेंस इज गिवन इन मीटर्स, हैड दे आस्क्ड इन किलोमीटर यू वुड हैव फाउंड इन किलोमीटर, राइट, बिकॉज आई मीन दिस इज इन किलोमीटर पर आवर एंड दीज टाइमिंग्स आर इन सेकेंड्स, सो मीटर पर सेकेंड वी विल हैव टू हैव द सेम यूनिट, ठीक है, 5 2 7 7 5 5, द आंसर इज 175, ओके, सो योर आंसर विल कम एज 175. नो वी डिड नॉट कैलकुलेट डायरेक्टली, राइट, वी कन्वर्टेड, कन्वर्ट किया तो सही, दैट्स व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू, यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट आल्सो, सो सी हाउ सिंपल इट इज इफ यू यूज दिस फ्रेमवर्क. क्वेश्चन रट लेते हैं, समझ में नहीं आता कि अलग अलग वेराइटीज आ गई क्वेश्चन की, राइट, इवन इफ इट इज एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन, जस्ट पुट इन दिस फ्रेमवर्क, यू विल ऑलवेज बी एबल टू डू द क्वेश्चन, ओके, इज इट क्लियर. 3 को कन्वर्ट क्यों करना है, इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड x, राइट, व्हाई डू यू कन्वर्ट इट, राइट, आई टुक x एज किलोमीटर पर आर, मैं सेम यूनिट में ले रहा हूं ना, व्हाई विल आई टेक इन मीटर पर सेकेंड, आई विल टेक इन सेम यूनिट दैट इज किलोमीटर पर आर, नाउ x माइनस 3 x माइनस 6, अब जब मैं दोनों साइड मल्टीप्लाई कर रहा हूं, मैं सेम नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई क्यों करूंगा, व्हाई विल आई मल्टीप्लाई बाय 5 बाय 18 बोथ साइड्स, फालतू 5 बाई 18 लिख के दोनों साइड कैंसिल करने का शौक है तो कर लो, बट वाई डू डू दिस, राइट, दिस इंटू दिस इज इक्वल टू दिस इंटू दिस, यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग विद सम कॉमन नंबर, वाई डू यू मल्टीप्लाई इट अगेन, आई मीन ऑन बोथ साइड्स, राइट, सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट, इफ यू आर हैबिचुअल ऑफ राइटिंग, यू हैव लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू स्पेंड, राइट इट लाइक दिस, देन यू विल से ओके आई विल कट दिस, केक में कैंडल लगा के बुझानी थोड़ी है, राइट, सो दैट्स वाई आई फाउंड दैट practice foolish, right, you light the candle and then blow it up, right, what is the purpose then, okay, so it is the same thing, you are multiplying and then cutting, why to do that, simply use this, right, how simple it is, see this framework is quite simple, you do not have to remember any formula, just remember this thing, right, speed is always relative speed, whenever there are two objects it will always be relative speed, ठीक है, डिस्टेंस विल सम ऑफ लेंथ इन केस ऑफ ऑल ट्रेन प्रॉब्लम्स, ठीक है, सो व्हेनेवर यू हैव ट्रेन प्रॉब्लम्स द डिस्टेंस इज सम ऑफ लेंथ, टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स मूविंग रिलेटिव स्पीड इज दिस, सर्कल में भाग रहे डिस्टेंस इज सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ सर्कल, राइट, जस्ट यूज दिस थिंग एंड गेट डन विद द आंसर्स, ओके, नाउ दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन लाइक टू पीपल लाइक टू ट्रेन्स, राइट, सो जो एक दो दूसरे शहर से आती हैं, हाउ टू डू दीज क्वेश्चंस, डिफरेंस ऑफ स्पीड इनटू मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ स्पीड इनटू डिफरेंस ऑफ स्पीड, जस्ट रिमेंबर टाइम इनटू स्पीड इज डिस्टेंस, राइट, so time is given to you, speed is given to you, right, that is, that becomes your difference, so in both the cases the distance is same, so just equate those. नाउ हाउ टू डू दीज प्रॉब्लम्स, ठीक है, इनको कैसे करते हैं. सो व्हेन टू ट्रेड्स जब सेम टाइम पे स्टार्ट होती हैं, राइट, जब सेम टाइम पे स्टार्ट होती हैं देन तो इट इज़ वेरी इजी. बट व्हेन दे स्टार्ट एट डिफरेंट टाइम्स व्हाट यू डू इज फर्स्ट स्टेप, लाइक आई विल टेल यू द स्टेप्स, वो स्टेप्स याद रख लो. मीन लॉजिकल थिंग है, इट्स नॉट समथिंग दैट सम मैजिकल थिंग. सो फर्स्ट मूव द फर्स्ट ट्रेन, फर्स्ट ट्रेन या कार जो भी है, अप टू द स्टार्ट टाइम ऑफ सेकेंड ट्रेन. ठीक है, सेकेंड स्टेप निकाल लो, फाइंड डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम, आई मीन रिमेनिंग डिस्टेंस. ठीक है, यू नो द रिलेटिव स्पीड, रिलेटिव स्पीड तो पता ही होती है. ठीक है, मतलब वो है तो डिस्टेंस अपॉन स्पीड क्या आ जाएगा, दैट इज इक्वल टू टाइम ऑफ मीटिंग. ठीक है, अब इसमें क्या हो रहा है कि एक ट्रेन 4 बजे स्टार्ट हो रही है, दूसरी ट्रेन 3:20 पे स्टार्ट हो रही है. ठीक है, तो 3:20 वाले को स्टार्ट कर देते हैं, इसको 4 बजे तक मूव करा देते हैं, 3:20 से 4 तक. हाउ मच विल इट कवर, इट इज कवरिंग एट 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर. ठीक है, स्टार्ट फ्रॉम लखनऊ, जहाँ से भी जा रही है, सो इट इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम लखनऊ 3:20 और 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो 4 आवर्स, 4 बजे तक कितना पहुँच जाएगी, 40 मिनट्स, 40 मिनट्स इट विल कवर 40 किलोमीटर. ठीक है, 4 अप टू 4 PM इट इज 40 किलोमीटर. तो रिमेनिंग डिस्टेंस निकाल दिया, रिमेनिंग डिस्टेंस कितना आया, 560. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इज द रिलेटिव स्पीड, 80 और 60. व्हेन दे आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट एंड्स एंड गोइंग टूवर्ड्स ईच अदर, रिलेटिव स्पीड इज सम ऑफ स्पीड. सो रिलेटिव स्पीड है 140. सो टाइम आ जाएगा, दिस इज डिस्टेंस, दिस इज स्पीड, टाइम विल बी 4. टाइम इज 4 मीन्स दे विल मीट आफ्टर 4 आवर्स. ठीक है, हाफ राउंड फ्रॉम डेली विल दे मूव. अब डेली वाली ट्रेन कितनी स्पीड से आ रही है, 80. सो आंसर विल बी 80 × 4, 320 किलोमीटर. ओके, सो वेन एवर यू हैव ट्रेन्स डिफरेंट स्टार्टिंग एट डिफरेंट टाइम्स, दिस इज हाउ यू डू. फर्स्ट मूव द फर्स्ट ट्रेन अप टू द टाइम वेन द सेकेंड ट्रेन इज स्टार्टिंग. ओके, देन फाइंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दम. 600 को डिवाइड मत करना रिलेटिव स्पीड से, राइट. फाइंड दैट, मूव दैट फर्स्ट थिंग, फिर जब दोनों स्टार्ट हो रही है वहां से डिवाइड करके उसमें निकाल दोगे. ठीक है, ऑल राइट. नाउ दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन बोट्स एंड स्ट्रीम्स. बोट्स एंड स्ट्रीम का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या होता है, अगर आप पानी के साथ बह रहे हो तो स्पीड बढ़ जाती है. इफ यू गो विद वाटर द स्पीड इंक्रीजेस, इफ यू गो अगेंस्ट वाटर द स्पीड डिक्रीजेस, राइट. सो क्या होता है, राइट, इफ यू गो अगेंस्ट वाटर दैट इज कॉल्ड अपस्ट्रीम स्पीड, दैट इज बोट माइनस स्पीड ऑफ स्ट्रीम्स. ठीक है, इफ यू गो विद वॉटर दैट इज कॉल्ड डाउन स्ट्रीम एंड दैट इज बोट प्लस स्ट्रीम. ठीक है, वेन यू एड दीज वट डू यू गेट, डी प्लस यू इज 2 times ऑफ बी, सो बी इज एवरेज ऑफ. ठीक है, वेन यू सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस, सो यू विल गेट डी माइनस यू इज इक्वल टू 2s, सो s इज इक्वल टू d माइनस u बाई 2. ऐसे निकल के आ जाती हैं. ठीक है, सो जस्ट रिमेंबर कि बोट की स्पीड इनका एवरेज होती है और अपस्ट्रीम इज लोअर, डाउनस्ट्रीम इज हायर. ओके, अच्छा, सो इसके लिए एक फ्रेमवर्क यूज कर लो, डब्स फ्रेमवर्क. ठीक है, टू स्पीड्स विल बी गिवन टू यू, टू यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सो हिज स्पीड इज 30 किलोमीटर इन स्टिल वाटर, सो बोट इज 30, सो वाटर इज रनिंग एट 10. सो डाउन हो जाएगी 40, अप हो जाएगी 20. ठीक है, ही टेक्स 3 hours टू रो अ प्लेस एंड बैक, हाउ फार इज द प्लेस. सपोज द डिस्टेंस इज डी, वॉट विल बी द टाइम, डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू डी, टाइम विल बी डी बाई 40 इन वन केस एंड सेकेंड केस डी बाई 20. दैट बिकम्स 3d/40, दैट इज इक्वल टू, ही इज टेकिंग द टोटल टाइम. सो यू एड टाइम्स इन केस ऑफ दिस, यू एड टाइम्स. ओके, जब बोट वाले क्वेश्चन में ऐसा आता है कि वो इतने टाइम में जा रहा है, इतने टाइम में टोटल टाइम इतना लग रहा है, सो टोटल टाइम इज ऑलवेज सम ऑफ टाइम्स. सो फाइंड t1 एंड t2 एंड ऐड देम. okay. So that makes it, that gives you d equal to 40 kilometer. So boat and stream question, they will generally say that this is the total time it takes in going this there and coming back. So add t1 and t2, you get the total time. Okay, t1 and t2, how do you find the distance upon the speeds? Okay, all right. A man can row 2 km upstream in 20 minutes and returns the same distance in 12 minutes. If due to a tide, the speed of the current gets doubled, how much time will he take to row the same distance upstream? So what we'll do in this case, see, this is the distance, time is this, right? So distance upon time is your distance upon time is your speed. So time is in minutes. Okay, so we'll convert it to hours, right? So 2 into 20 by 60, 6. So this is upstream speed is 6. Downstream is, he's covering in 12, right? Downstream in speed is 10. So average is both 8, 2. Okay, now what is happening? It is saying that due to a tide, the speed of the current gets doubled, right? So if the current speed gets doubled, right, this will become 4, right? Stream speed will become 4, boat speed will remain as same, right? Boat speed will remain same. What will be the upstream speed now? Upstream speed will be 4, okay? Now he has to cover, how much time will he take to cover the same distance, which is 2 kilometer? 2 by 4 is half an hour, right, which is 30 minutes. Now some people, what they might do is, they will say ki speed of current doubles trouble. So they think ki speed double ho gayi to upstream speed bhi, ye bhi double ho jayegi. No, no. I mean, kuch log kya kar denge, ise upstream ko 3 le lenge. Right? So speed will not, this will not change the speed of boat. Okay, some people will think ki if stream flows at the double rate, right, upstream will become half. No, that is not the case. Okay, so only this speed will change. This will remain as it is. Okay. All right, so these were some questions on time, speed and distance. We followed different, we saw different varieties of questions, right? And we saw like questions on trains, we saw the framework, TSD framework, how to solve questions. So there are a couple of questions for you, right? So please answer them in the comments of this video. Okay, and these are our mentors at GradeUp, those who teach you for these MBA entrance examinations. I'm sure you must have seen their classes on YouTube and GradeUp app. Okay, and we have launched this CAT 2021 percentile booster course for the ones who are who have already taken CAT and want to improve their scores to a higher percentile, right? So that is the batch that we have recently launched. Okay, and this weekend we are going to have a All India Mega Mock Challenge of Quant for CAT. So in case you want to take that, you can appear for this for free. Okay. If you enjoyed this class, please do like the video. I hope you got some new insights, how to solve time, speed, distance problems. in lesser time than you probably were seeing. And as I told you that you do not have to remember formula for this, right? And just see that like what is the what is this thing, right? Your like the TSD approach, which I told you in most of the problems, it will help you, right? So if your concepts are clear, you do not have to remember formulae for everything, right? So just go with the basics and get your questions right. Okay, so all right, so that's it for today. Thanks for attending the class. I hope you enjoyed today's class. So don't forget to like the session. And tomorrow I think we have one, I think it's on time and work. You can check the schedule. I will be checking it tomorrow morning. Okay, so thank you. Have a great night ahead. Goodbye.